Hi, I'm David Manning, a Principal Environmental Specialist with the Sonoma County Water Agency. I manage our natural resources programs. And what you're looking at here is Mirabel Inflatable Dam. It's a seasonal dam. It's actually a water-filled rubber bladder during the low flow season of the year. So when the winter rains come up and there's high flow in the river, what you see behind me is still there. It just lies flush on the stream bed. We inflate it in the springtime, sometime between April and June, and it typically stays up until November or December. But it can be inflated at any time of the year that the water agency needs to increase its ability to deliver water to the 600,000 customers in our service area. We get about half of the water supply benefit we need during our peak periods of the year from the water stored behind this dam. We pump that water into a series of infiltration ponds that we use to recharge the groundwater. We also use all of the water backed up behind the dam. It sits about 11 feet above the stream bed and backs water up for nearly 3 miles upstream. There are a series of wells upstream from this point that also benefit from having that increased level of water in the river. It facilitates groundwater pumping upstream. This site has been the focus of a lot of fisheries monitoring and study over the last 10 years. The dam was first put in place in the late 1970s. Chinook salmon, coho salmon, and steelhead were listed under the Endangered Species Act between 1996 and 1999, and the Water Agency began a pretty intensive investigation of the impacts of this facility on the upstream movement of adult salmon and then the downstream movement of juvenile salmon and steelhead as they head out to the ocean. So we've been studying the movement of fish past this site using a few different techniques. Right now, here in the fall, when Chinook salmon are migrating upstream and steelhead and coho salmon are beginning their migration, we have fish ladders on either side of the dam that enable fish to get past the facility. You'll see fish trying to jump over the height of the dam. Most are unsuccessful, so they need fish ladders to help get them upstream. We have a video monitoring system on the fish ladders on either side of the dam. That is an underwater camera that takes a time-lapse image 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We have a staff of biologists and technicians that watch those videos and count physically the number of fish that move upstream past this site. We see in terms of the Chinook salmon, in the past 10 years we've been doing this monitoring, between about 1,200 and 6,000 fish pass upstream during the time that we have the dam in place. The migration extends beyond the period that we have the dam inflated because river flow comes up, we no longer need the dam and we deflate it, but fish are still moving upstream past this site. That's particularly true for the steelhead. Most of them return to the river in December, January, February, and March. At that time, the dam is down. So this count that we get is largely based on Chinook salmon, the first of the fish returning to the river. So this entire facility is critical to our water supply, and we're very concerned about the environmental impacts. It's been reviewed extensively by the National Marine Fisheries Service, the California Department of Fish and Game, and our own biological research and monitoring over the last 10 years. And we've been able to demonstrate that we can have our water supply safely meet the needs of fish as they pass by this facility. A couple of enhancements and improvements will make that even better. But this site is an incredibly valuable resource for us to gauge the number of fish that move upstream in the Russian River and downstream every year. And we're very pleased that it doesn't impact or preclude the migration of fish up and down the Russian River.